Shut your mouth and look at my wad. Loads of money.
This is a journey into money. Loads of money.
Arnon. It's loads of money.
They spell loads of money, probably.
Made a right load of tennis in Nolly this week.
Well, let's watch out for the ladies.
Loads of, loads of, loads of.
This is my bread and butter. My bird's bite's free and my car's a nutter. Loads of money is a shout I utter as I wave my wand and the kids is in the gutter. Derek B on your bike.
This is an insult to our intelligence.
Shut your mouth.
Nurse, come and attend to loads of money. He's got too much money.
Probably. Oh, more money in Stock Aitken and Dennis Waterman put together.
United, loads.
Now that's a final score there.
Pump up the football, pump up the football.
Hey, check this out. Sorry, mate, don't take checks. Just loads of money.
Sing a song of sixpence, a pocket full of dosh. Dibble, 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 bosh, bosh, bosh. Sing a song of sixpence, a pocket full of
fellas, we are returned, and I am closing my 100 tabs that I had open before this stream for some reason. Let's get music on.
Then she sends the kids to school, sees them off with a small kiss.
We could start at the beginning of a new song, that would be even better. Anyway, I have returned, and I am once again drawing some bullshit. I had, as the title suggests, I have had a brilliant slash terrible idea. The idea is the same idea I've been having for several months, and the idea is include streaming fan art in your coursework because it's the only thing you can actually motivate yourself to finish on time. My paint water is still purple from yesterday, so... But continuing with the theme of utterly scuffed for the setup. But I don't know how to explain this properly, but basically, I remembered that I have glow-in-the-dark paint, which, now that I'm looking around, I have no idea where the fuck I left. Yes, I do. It's down here. Behold. Glowy shit. But yeah, I have glow-in-the-dark paint, and I was thinking, hey, I need to do a practice run for the glow-in-the-dark paint before I actually use it on something that's properly coursework related. So fuck it. Who's associated with, basically it was several trains of thought happening at once, which eventually led to the thought, let's draw Bilzo but with a skeleton that's only visible in glow-in-the-dark paint. And now we're here. That's the entire stream summarised in about 30 seconds flat. So we are once again doing some bullshit and drawing. So yes, it begins. I have actually drawn Bilzo on stream before, but it was a very quick drawing when I was just drawing a whole bunch of people from the BDSMP all on one stream. 3, 4, 5. And the theme of shaking the table aggressively while drawing begins already. Also, I'm gonna tag Bilzo in this as fan art when I eventually post it, but I hope he doesn't see it on Twitter because the stuff I've put in his DMs, because fucking my IRLs have sick sense of humour, is interesting. Where's my rubber? Oh, it's over here. Plop. Yeah, I was gonna go live several hours earlier, but I ended up watching Encanto for the third time this week instead. Anyway, stream has once again begun. We are on schedule. We are streaming at a reasonable hour. A rarity for me, I know. I know I said yesterday that it was my last day of like holiday and first day of college. I was incorrect. College actually starts tomorrow. And now that I said that on stream, with any luck, the universe will compensate around me and it'll end up starting the day after tomorrow and we can just continue this forever. Unfortunately, I do not think that miracle will be granted. But luckily for my sleep-deprived brain, it's the rest of the week online learning. So I don't actually have to pretend to be presentable in front of 200 other college students first day back. But yeah, this is what we call a mild attempt at making streaming a more regular thing. I'm not really sure how I'm gonna do the whole skeleton thing yet, but we will cross that bridge when we come to it. I don't know what I'm gonna do with the big negative space that is the completely white shirt, but we're gonna think of something. Hang on, you can see the reference image, you can see what I'm going for. You can also just entirely see the reflection of the lamp. That's fine, probably. I kind of cropped off the top bit of this because I couldn't find a way to fit it in the photo that didn't just have a bunch of unnecessary space around the sides, so... we're just gonna imagine the top like 3 inches of this page aren't here. Yeah, it's all in shot, okay, that's good. I realised that I could put the microphone so that it's up rather than at an angle, so the camera's at a slightly different angle, or my elbow may be slightly more in the way. But you know what, it's probably fine. there's literally just a complete negative space here. This is probably fine. Maybe I'll add something in the glow in the dark paint. There's a few areas of like mild shading, but not much. Let's see if I can turn the contrast up on here so I can see it a little bit better. Oh my god, I could just like the brightness in general. Oh fun, it's already almost at max. That's interesting. Now we have the unbearable distinction of what is chair, what is hair, which is what always happens when I draw people with dark hair with dark backgrounds. We're gonna work it out, I think. Why have I opened this tab? That was that's the tab I wanted open. I don't know what he's holding, but we're just gonna kind of incorporate into this image. I think it's part of the headphones. I can see the wire is, but I'm not sure what, like, this thing is. See, the most useful thing about those people on Twitter who, for some reason, set their profile pictures as content creator spaces is that, Jesus Christ, does it provide a lot of reference images for fan artists, because they tend to pick the nice photos. I hate drawing hands. Not as much as, like, curly hair, but it's, it, like, they're up. A little bit of the mic peeking through in the corner, but we'll include it because why not? The knuckles that are always the most annoying part of drawing any hand. I'm not sure where to place them. Why'd you have to kill my cat? Why'd I have to take you back? And time I play the empire. I don't know why. Some lights on in an empty bar. Wow, I can't believe Lovejoy predicted Twitter and time.
Talk about what I want to do, 'cause all I want to do is turn back time at least a couple Tuesdays to before I found one life turn to a set it last time, but I'm not afraid of anything.
The snuffle seems wrong, but we're going with it. What the fuck is happening with that hand? Oh, there's like cut. They call this the power of having the original file you added the grid with. AKA, why you shouldn't close your GIMP projects. For this is coming along surprisingly quickly, which is good. Is that partially why I decided to do this was today, because I put a load of paint in here and I don't want it to go to waste or anything. Chair makes it difficult to kind of see. It's a difficult to see the fucking roof line, so. Let's see if I can dupe that bit better. There we go. Zoom fingers and touchscreen laptops in general. I can't tell what this is. I don't think it's like a black bar from a photo of editing issue. I think it's just like a. On the microphone? I don't know. Angels sang out in an immaculate chorus down from the heavens. Bless Bilzel and his affinity for the bandana for meaning I don't have to draw a hairline. Which could shatter bones into the crotch of Indiana Jones, who fell over on the ground, writhing in pain as Batman changed back into Bruce Wayne. But Chuck saw.
Many lives are claimed, but eventually the champion stood
like for a southern header.
Mr. Rogers in a bloodstained sweater.
This is the ultimate showdown. Ultimate destiny. Good guys, bad guys, and explosions. As far as the eye can see, and only one will survive.
No big round here. Straight down. Circles at angles are another thing I dislike drawing, but you know what? We're just going with it. There we go.
Maybe together we can get somewhere, any place is better.
I know the whole factory plant thing's a bit of a joke, and I'm just saying, Bilzo simultaneously looks like how people draw Satnap and young Wilbur. I'm just saying, if that was a most likely to have been made in a factory. Maybe I should have included a bit of the headphone thing. I mean, a bit of this line so I could see the headphone height better. It's probably fine.
See, my old man's got a problem. Live with a bottle less than way it is. He says his body's too old for working. His body's too young to look like his. My mom went off and left him. She wanted more from life than he could give. I said, somebody's got to take care of him. So I quit school, and that's what I did.
I'm doing the facial features last, which is rare, because I usually end up doing this first, but oh, we're kind of just taking this as it comes.
You got a fast car. Is it fast enough that we could fly away? We gotta make a decision. Leave tonight or live and die this way.
So I remember we were driving in your car. Speed so fast, felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling that I belonged. And I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone.
Bilzo has the perfect kind of hair to draw. It's dead straight and quite long, which is always just easy as hell to like sketch out the general shape of. Plus, he has traditional British lighting of a slightly yellow bulb. Colour contrast between that and the luminous LED screens. Which always have white light because computers tend to actually be new.
First, feel like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And I had a feeling that I belong. And I had a feeling I could be someone, be someone, be someone. You got a fast car. I got a job, pays all our bills. You stay out drinking late at the bar. See more of your friends than you do of your kids.
It's in the last hairstrand here.
Thought maybe together you and me fine, and I got no plans.
I don't think I'm gonna do what I did with yesterday's drawing, where I just did it with one brush. I think I'm actually gonna break out these bad boys, or at the very least this one, which dried at a really weird angle. Why is it bad?
First, I felt like I was drunk. City lights lay out before us, and your arm felt nice wrapped around my shoulder. And
I feel like it's got to leave that so much as it goes back in the shape.
I had a feeling that I belong, and I had a feeling I could be someone.
There you go, King. Regain your status as a decent brush.
You got a fast car. Fast enough so you can fly away. You gotta make a decision. Leave tonight, live and die this way.
What's that? Just a random bit of plastic on this. The things you find when you get a new piece of paper in a sketchbook. There we go. It's not strands of hair. It's headphones being weirdly reflective. I'm stupid, but I'm a genius. I know you can see this on the stream. Oh no, you can't see this on the stream. Trust me, it's fucking strange looking. Oh yeah, I forget the angle the camera's either. It's different to the one on stream itself. You know what? Let's just. Hello, cam. So everyone say hello to the camera. Like, what is that? What is that? And now the laptop's on the fucking cable. Brilliant. There we go. Fixed. I think it's headphone, so I'm just gonna continue to assume it's headphone. And act as if it's headphone rather. This side of the head. I'm drawing in this section. Like the sections of light and dark, knowing full well the last time I did hair, I did this entire process and then just painted over it anyway and ignored it. That's that for that side of the head. A few strands of hair I got in.
The ship is sort of sinking, so let's start drinking before we start thinking. This is the life. This is the life. Bo 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 bo. This is the life. Bo 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 bo. This is the life. Bo 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 bo. Bohemia.
There we go. That's pretty much blocked it out, and then there's like an area of highlight down. Another similar area around here. We don't talk about Bruno. But it was my wedding day. Lots of highlight here, so I'm just going to draw lines. There's one big area of shadow here. Big area of highlight. Another one. He may end up with slightly purple hair, as yesterday's subject ended up with slightly purple skin, but you know, we roll with the punches.
Hey,
There we go. That's the basic outline done. Only half an hour. That's pretty good. My hair is so... It looks so short. I haven't had it cut particularly recently. It just looks short for some reason. Anyway, facial features time. I had a lot of trouble with the facial features last time, which is probably entirely my own fault based on the fact that I was doing a duplicated face rather than just a face. The septum piercing helps like ground it. Nose shine like that. Strawberry seed around here. That's probably a better term for like the weird bit on top of the nose that's slightly darker due to the like cavity that I call it strawberry seed because it kind of looks like strawberry seeds. I don't know. You know, the outside of strawberry? Yeah. Got the bridge slightly wrong. I hope I check the VOD for this and the sound isn't completely fucked. But I've got the music at a good volume for me. I've never been able to work out what it is Mariano says in that song. I know he sings Isabella, but then he says, like, don't you see, or something like that, but I'm not sure if that's just someone else's part I'm hearing overlapped. Break of day, the dawn is here. Johnny's up and pacing. Compromise or persevere. His mind is racing. Johnny has no guide. Johnny wants to hide. Can he make his mark if he gives up his spark? Johnny can't decide. Susan longs to live by the sea. This is going surprisingly well for a first draft of the sketch. Maybe this drawing is slightly blessed, who knows. I maintain that that line is absolutely tongue-in-cheek. we are back at the Wombles. I say that every time we reach the Wombles. This is actually our first time reaching the Wombles this stream. It just feels an appropriate line to say whenever I hear the intro to this song. What the hell is happening here? It's like, I think it's eyelashes, but because this is probably a screenshot from a stream, I don't know, I sourced this photo from Twitter. Yes, I think it's eyelashes that are just like mid blink or something, but. This is how I don't get how people can draw people like direct from still life, because if there's like even the slightest motion, I'm just like, oh, what is going on? I decided this was a good art day for some reason. At fucking 9:15 at night. Whenever I think of like whenever I'm doing a drawing that's going well, I always hear that one clip in my head of Delightful explaining like what a good art day is and stuff. Because that one like 4-year-old video just summarized it perfectly. There we go. I really like how the faces turned out on this one. It looks kind of bad from this angle, but you know, we're going with it. It's really trust the process at this point. Hang on. Let me see the stream. I'm gonna get this at the good angle for the camera. So that angle is straight on, I think. There we go. Boom. Paint time, fellas. I don't have a tissue or anything to wipe this on. I just kind of put it back into the paint, into like the tissue that's the basis of this, because it can always use more moistening. Oh no, the acrylic's begun to dry. It's always the one you touch that doesn't, isn't it? Just plop that there because I know I'll need it eventually. I don't understand how stay wet palettes can keep, like, professional stay wet palettes can keep paint, like, properly wet for weeks, and this one can't even do overnight. I'm gonna put a post-it note under this just so I can do the corner easier. We're gonna ignore the questionable contents of the post-it note, it's just... It was on the floor, and then I just brought it up here just in case I needed it for anything. Which apparently I did, so, you know, good call by me. As for always, we're gonna need a really dark brown, because apparently I only am capable of drawing people with really dark brown hair. So we're gonna start off with a fair amount of black, because why the hell not just reverse the order from yesterday? And then add a fair bit of the rest of the colours. You know what, let's just chuck in all the red, because this paint's not surviving like a third day. The brushes have fallen, but we're going with it. I need like another light like over here somewhere, just so this isn't just complete shadow. Thinking about the fact that I have to be awake at 8 a.m. I'm not looking forward to it. This has just gone really deep red for some reason. Bring this back. I suppose I could start the red sections now, but... Start with darker, work lighter. A dark base means it'll probably be more opaque in the end, so can't complain. Bring that a bit further over there, so it might have messed up the lighting for the face cam, but oh well. That one's over the face cam. I don't know why I'm being so precise on the roundness of the circle. I'm going to be painting in the rest of black in a minute. Fellas, we've created the flag of Japan. Bleeding through to the next page? Not really. No more than the last drawing did for this one. So. Background's gonna be a deep purple, so I'm just gonna chuck a bunch of stuff on here to clean off the brush. Maybe I can make the background red, that'll work.
Myself the question, what's the right direction?
bigger brush time. Aggressively used bigger brush time, but bigger brush time nonetheless. MegaMech69, awesome username. Welcome to the chat, we are drawing Bilzo. I don't recognize that emote, is that... It could be a cat or is it Crumb? I'm going to hover over it. It's time for me to decide. Oh, it's a Devi cat. I have not heard of that channel. Anyway, welcome to the chat. Hello, hello. That's cool. Presuming you got it through the art category then. To check her out. Keep knocking the house. Oops. What is it about the color red and just being absolutely unbearable to paint with? I thought it was this cheap poster paint red that I was using before that was causing me to have red like crumbs all over the page, but it's happening with this one as well. And this is proper acrylic. Who knows? Yeah, I know my stream's kind of quiet. I need a cloud lifter for the mic. Is the music too loud? That's one thing I can fix. Because if the music's too loud, like compared to my voice, I can fix that, but just the general audio being quiet's kind of... Without a cloud lifter, there's not much I can do about it. But if it's all just really quiet, that's... If it's like, I'm quiet but the music's loud, I can fix that, but if it's just everything's quiet, there's not much I can do about it. Just my voice. Okay, I can turn the music down. Hang on. There we go, is that a bit better? I think that should be a bit different balance. I've turned the music down a little bit. And to stream, I'm just on a laptop, OBS, and a Rode microphone. But it does not have a cloud lifter, so unfortunately it is quite quiet. Yeah, it's all good. It's all right in OBS. It's like, it's lowing the green, but it is on maximum, like, setting. Like, I can turn it all the way down and then all the way back up again, but realistically, my mic needs a cloud lifter to boost it to be louder. I don't know. There might be a cheaper alternative to a cloud lifter, but if there is, I haven't found it. Thanks for the advice, though. This paint has been getting redder. I think it's because it's like dissolving a bit. Yeah, it's up as hard as it can get on my, like, box thing that takes it from the mic to the computer. But I need, like, this little... I'm not the best when it comes to, like, the technology of all of it, but basically I need another small box to connect between the mic and the computer that'll make the microphone louder. But it's, like, 100 quid, so I do not have one yet. Good, thank you for asking. How are you doing in this fine day of this Twitch chat? Yeah. This is technically art coursework while also being streamer fan art, so I'm just kind of like, my college like goes back tomorrow, so I'm just like sort of rushing it, but not really. Because I haven't really done much in the way of art coursework other than this and like one other thing that I streamed yesterday. Oh, I'm glad you're well. I love all the little emotes you're using, they're very cute. I need a buffer sheet of paper between this and the one behind. Nice. Oh, Jesus Christ, I just got a desktop notification. It's not my only medium, but I'm on sort of a acrylic painting kick at the moment, but I also do oil, and I can do a lot of paintings in brush markers. I can actually show you the brush marker stuff. It's in this book. We're just gonna hope and pray that this being slightly wet doesn't mean I can't change pages. Something just fell over. But this is in acrylic paint. This is acrylic paint. Is this visible? Hang on, let me see. You can actually see what I'm showing. There we go. This is acrylic paint. This is acrylic paint. And then... There we go. Turn it around a bit. Everything's falling. This is pen, like brush marker. Half of my paint's just fell off the table, oh dear. I'll retrieve them at some point. But yeah, paint's my favourite medium at the moment, but it always flip-flops between a bunch of different ones. And I also use oil, but I don't have any oil with me, like, to show. Thank you. Oh, thank you, Florentine. I was about to pronounce your username incredibly wrong, because my chat box is tiny, so it puts on two lines, and it's just Florentine E. But thank you, thank you. Yeah. For some reason, every time I draw in this book, rather than my actual proper, like, professional sketchbook, I'm happier with the drawings I make. Which is weird, because this fell off the back of a lorry, this sketchbook. The other one? Yeah, I can do. Hang on. It's just back here. Let me see if what I've got in here that's actually decent. Where's the drawing? That's on separate paper. Hang on. have to move the wet one, but oh well. These are some of my drawings from my actual sketchbook. So this one's pencil, back when my hair was still long. That's an oil paint one, although obviously this is just a photo of it, but you get the idea. And turn around. This one is also an acrylic. I've got a bunch more stuff in here, but this book is absolutely massive. Let's see if I can pull up an image on stream, maybe. Aw, thank you. That's very sweet of both of you. My paint is stuck to my brush. This is what I get for leaving acrylic out overnight. It's all just decided it's going to clump together.
FL0 Rentine has joined the localized cult.
Welcome to the chat, Florentine. I forgot how loud my own desktop notifications were. That has happened twice now. But yes, welcome to... I forgot this. Well, I think it's localized cult. I've got that set too. This is what happens when you set your alerts at 3 in the morning. There's probably a way to turn that down to a natural volume that doesn't jump scare me out of my skin, but I have not found it. Yes, this is my latest attempt at shoehorning streamer fan art into this. My notification alerts? It's just like a Stream Elements thing. Yeah. When I first started streaming almost a year ago, I had none of this stuff set up, but I basically just forced myself to watch like 4 hours of tutorials of how to get like stream stuff working, and I was just like, I think I have a very small understanding of it now. Yeah, it's just a Stream Elements page where anytime someone follows or anything, I get that yelling at me. It's the same thing I use for the like most recent follower thing on top of the screen and all that. When I first started streaming, like drawing and stuff, I literally just used my phone, which is, I'm still basically just using my phone, but I think it's a bit nicer to have a stream that has like music and stuff playing in the background than purely a phone stream. Phone's carrying a little bit less of the weight now that's not being the camera, streaming device, and microphone. Yeah. It's only been the last couple of streams I worked out how to get a decent camera angle for this. I do have Discord. Yeah. I do not remember my thing, but I can probably copy-paste it in the chat if you want. Click through 5 of the wrong tabs. There we go. That's my number thingy majig. I don't have a Discord, but I am on Discord. I'm sorry, light mode, I know, I'm a heathen. My eyesight is already terrible, but light mode probably doesn't help. Discord is the one app you think I wouldn't use light mode for, because it's like the one like major website that doesn't have it as a default. But alas. Trying to get these weird little, like, I don't know what it is about red paint, but it always causes my paper to like buckle and leave little crumbs everywhere. I don't know what they are. It's just like bits of paper that have just come apart. I suppose that's what I get for using a cheapest chips notebook, but... I've been painting this just progressively redder for the last like 10 minutes. I should probably... If you cannot tell, I am procrastinating drawing the rest of the face and everything. I think it's probably best I even that out with more coats later. Return of the slightly smaller brush. Bit of red, bit of, Jesus Christ, the blue has coagulated even more than the red had. And a little bit of yellow. Yeah, red's the best color. Now I gotta mix brown for the hair. You'd think brown would be an easy colour to mix based on the fact it's just shove everything else together and you get it in the end, but it's not. See, I barely added any blue to this, and yet it is on violently blue in my little mixing tray thing. The issue is, you never really know what colour the paint's going to be until it's on the thing. Yeah, purple's a good one. I have a slight personal vendetta against purple at the moment, though. Because one of those oil paintings I showed you in my other book, where the face is just like entirely blue-purple, it is so hard to make purple with oil paint if you don't have like a specific, like, already purple oil paint. Like, mixing acrylic to get purple just from like the core, like the big three, red, blue, yellow, is alright, but doing it in oil is just so difficult for no reason. I mean, there's probably a reason, but I don't know what it is. Paint's deciding not to be ridiculously transparent today, so taking that as a win. Yeah. I guess, weird thing is, acrylic and oil are like my main paint. Like go-to colours now, but I used to hate both of these mediums, especially acrylic. Personally, I blame high school art classes. My brown is once again too yellow, so I'm actually gonna have to search for the paint that fell on the floor a minute ago. Got him. There we go, bit of paint in the palette that's not horribly crusty and dry. Ah, no problem. Thanks for hanging out, Florentine. I hope I have been pronouncing your username correctly. I have a weird little salute thing to say goodbye, I don't know what that was, but we're going with it. Ah, good, good. See you then. Why is this still orange? I meant to make this simultaneously two red and two blue. It's a miracle of colour, and it would be very appreciated if it wasn't so incredibly annoying. Yeah, that blue is just hardened completely. Don't. My brush is dripping on the table. My blue paint is entirely hardened. It's being cast out. Oh yeah, gold paint markers are awesome. I've never really gotten the hang of paint markers, but gold paint is just brilliant. But now I need fresh blue, and this blue maybe has some in it? Hey, the last dredges of this paint I've had for like 7 years? The last dredges of Crafter's acrylic. Which looks about as beaten up as it is. How do you even... So how do paint markers work exactly? I've never really used them, but I know that Poskas are like everyone's like go-to when they talk about them. At least I think Poskas are paint markers. They could just be regular markers. I'm not entirely sure. See, that's still too purple. So if you've only recently started using them, oh, hang on. This is how you think I hate myself because I would always avoid it instead of using it. That's a mood. If you're only recent to them, what's your go-to medium before like paint markers and stuff? Oh, I think I may have gotten the brown to be not purple. Oh yeah, cell shading. That's cool. Just gonna lay down a baseline with this because it's deciding it's gonna be transparent today after all. And a good base layer always makes the paint look more opaque in the end. But it is indeed slightly too purple. Ah, that's cool. One pencil, that's impressive. That sounded very sarcastic. I'm sorry, I didn't mean it to be. I've always been pretty terrible at drawing black and white drawings. Recently in my college, my art teacher was just like, right, none of you have enough tonal contrast in your pieces, and she just made us all do an A2 like graphic pencil drawing, and I've never seen like 10 people look more annoyed at having to draw something. It's pretty cool you've mastered with one pencil though. Yeah. It's really cool if you can draw purely in black and white though. I always find that so difficult. Put a little of that on there. my card shading. Yeah, that's cool. When I first started out drawing, I started out doing all my stuff digitally. And I still have, like, saved files of all my original drawings from when I was, like, 11 years old. They're not good. They are not good. We all gotta start somewhere, right? Somehow make this a cooler brown to do the other side of the head. And like this area. Yeah, better start seeing them later. Yeah, when I first started drawing, most of my drawings, some of which I think still exist maybe, even like the physical paper ones, they're basically just copying off VivCpop and stuff like that. I wonder how many artists who are like that age now and starting are gonna have like, I wonder what their artists that they're copying off of are gonna be. Damn, that's cool. That's quite recent. I started posting art online in 2016, but it's very bad. Oh yeah, more seriously. That's cool. I don't really know when I started taking art more seriously, but the point that always sticks out for me is I did this one oil painting in like late 2019, and I remember thinking like, huh, I don't hate this 3 weeks after I painted it. And I think that's when I knew I was like, ah, this, I like drawing. I think I'm gonna do this properly. Put in some of like the lighter highlights into the hair, but it's just being absorbed into like the dark brown. That's cool, you found out I take art classes. That's interesting. Because I'm like completely the opposite. I have always just drawn and drawn and drawn and drawn in my free time, and I used to hate my like my school art classes. I was just like, I think my go-to line when I was younger was always like, oh yeah, I love art, but I hate the art class. I think it was just because like my art class wanted me to draw like still lifes and stuff and wouldn't just let me doodle random like anime figures. That's cool. cool if you managed to find out you were good at this through like art classes. That's really cool. I think I might have to wait for this dark brown to dry a bit more before I try and go in with the lighter yellow. Oh yeah. No class that has like people who are really good friends with each other has ever been a productive lesson. No shot, no shot. I was a lot more productive in my art class at like the beginning. Because I didn't really know anyone in it that well, but now like my actual art class is just like, it's just basically a family and nothing gets done, ever. Yeah, lessons with friends are the best, but they're not productive. I may have added a bit too much pink to this. I don't know what it is, but this like pink oil paint I bought at Hobbycraft years ago is just ridiculously good at making any color gray. No matter what it is, you add the pink to it, it just becomes grey. Well, slightly purple-grey, but same difference. I swear I can just add yellow to this forever and it doesn't get any less purple. Ridiculous colour. Look at that. I can add like this much yellow to this and it will not get any less purple. Of course, now that I have spoken that into the universe, it's gonna get way less purple just to contradict me because Sod's Law is in full effect. Yep. I think this should be able to break through even the darkest brown section. Yeah. There we go, that's managed to break through the darkness a little bit. Cool. Yeah, that's cool. Graphic design. Oh, that sounds really cool. I'm in my last year of British college, so I'm still stuck doing fine art, but I can't wait to be able to expand and do other things as well. Gotta combine the browns and somehow make this into a cohesive color. Aw, thank you. I'm hoping to do art at uni, so. Hopefully I've got a little bit of potential. Maybe. I don't know. Is this grey enough? Yeah, it's slightly greyer. There we go. We win these eventually. Oh, thank you. Yeah, my Instagram is like my tiniest platform ever. I should post on there more often, I think. Thank you for the follow, though. I can't see any notifications or anything for stuff like that at the moment because my phone is my camera. To lay down lighter areas this time because on the other side they just got absorbed, so maybe if I start with them on this side then I have a fighting chance. Favorite subject? I like drawing people the best. I pretty much always do portraits. I'm not too good at landscapes, but maybe I just need to practice more, I don't know. But my favorite thing to draw is people. But my least favorite thing to draw of people is curly hair, which is unfortunate because that is exactly what I have. Getting the detail in on all the coils and stuff is the bane of my existence. The baseline test that my school always makes you do every year for like art ability when you're younger is like draw a self-portrait, and I'm just there like, for fuck's sake. I knew a girl who had like jet black, fully straight hair, and she just had it on easy mode because she could just like color it all in dark and be like, yep, that's what it is. Yeah, practice makes perfect, yeah. I have once again accidentally made purple while aiming for dark brown. For some reason it will just not go brown. Purple's gonna assassinate me in my sleep, I know. I don't know what it is, but I always get purple and brown like completely mixed up. I don't know if it's just the fact that I'm in like slightly dim lighting or what. But I always see them as each other. I've got like a bright white light shining over it, so it's not as bad over the palette, but I prefer drawing in the summer for many reasons, one of which being I can draw outside, the main one being it doesn't get dark at 3:30. granite, it's a lot easier to see colours accurately in natural light. Plus, you get better cast shadows when you're taking reference photos and stuff. What kept me inspired? I don't really know. I always just find things that I want to draw for, like, sometimes I'll go for like weeks and I'll just draw absolutely nothing because I'm like, I can't think of, like, nothing's like speaking to me. That sounds fucking pretentious as hell, but like this one, what I'm drawing at the moment literally came to me when I was rooting around a box upstairs looking for something else. I found my glow-in-the-dark paint and I was like, I know exactly what I can do with this. Because basically, I think I explained it at the beginning of the stream, but no one was here for that. Yeah, art block. Yeah. This whole stream, the idea is, I'm doing this whole drawing, but once it's done and dry, I'm going to be adding this paint in a second layer with a, like, skeleton thing over the face. Because I don't know if you know who the guy I'm drawing is, but it's a streamer called Bilzo. And his whole thing is that he has, like, a skeleton avatar and stuff. He shows his face and stuff, but like he has a skeleton avatar for like games and stuff. So I'm going to be superimposing the skeleton thing over the top. Oh, thank you. Yeah, I came up with that idea literally when I was just like, I saw this like upside down in a box and I was like, oh my god, the glow in the dark paint I bought when I was like 11 years old. I have an idea of what I can do with this. And then I was like, I ran downstairs and sat upstream. I was like, yes, I know what I'm doing today. Sometimes I'll go like weeks without having anything like that come to me and be like, yes, this is what you're going to draw today. Yeah, that's fair. But yeah, watching streamers kind of helps me be inspired to draw stuff. Like, I follow a whole bunch of artists on Twitter. I don't watch as many art streams as maybe I should, but I follow a bunch of artists on Twitter, and sometimes I'll see, like, someone I follow do something, and I'm like, oh my god, that's inspired me, I've got to draw something like whatever that person's drawn. That's kind of how I learnt to draw at the beginning as well. But I find streamers as a good source of, like reference images and inspiration and stuff. Like, this guy, and all the other streamers who are kind of, like, in his circles. It's kind of a joke that some of the big streamers in the circle have, like, their own personal artists, like, they're fucking Roman emperors or Tudor kings or something. I find people with, like, the kind of, like, out there personalities you need to be the kind of streamer that they are tend to provide for pretty good reference images. I don't have the photo on me, but I might have it, be able to show it on stream. Where it's a streamer I drew. Apologies for the presence of light mode. But it's a streamer I drew. Well, I suppose he's technically a streamer again now. A while back. Oh, Twitter and your ability to load so slowly on my internet. Who did stuff like... scroll. There we go. Do stuff like... dress up in elaborate costume. Is this gonna load? Christ alive. There we go. That's very poorly visible, but it's the best I can do at this precise second to show it on stream. And now all my cables are tangled. Oh dear. There we go. That's vaguely in the right place. But they do things like that and have elaborate costumes and bits and skits and stuff. And I usually find inspiration there if I can't think of anything else to draw. Thanks. Yeah, that's one of my... it's not older drawings, but it's from like May of last year. find like general like streamers and content creators and that are pretty good sources of just like ideas of stuff to draw. Because it's like I watch their content enough that I'm like invested in them as like personalities and stuff who put stuff out there. And sometimes they do ridiculous shit and I'm like, I want to draw this. And whenever something hits me like that, here I come to Twitch, drawing random shit for a few hours. Yeah, yeah. Art challenges. Yeah, that's. Oh, yeah. I always find that draw this in your styles are really good ones to do. It's like, I don't have to go through the mental process of like finding a good image myself, and it's just like. It's cool to see, especially if you're if you do a draw this in your style, and then you look at like what everyone else did, it's just like, right. What do I like from their pieces and what can I nick to put in my own style? Yeah. Yeah, if you're looking to try a draw list in your style, there's always like 500 going on Twitter on any given time. Any medium or any like fandom you can think of, someone will be running one. I'm just looking outside because I realise you are new to the stream, but a regular occurrence of my streams is a little segment I like to call Screaming Cat ASMR. In which my cat makes out that she is absolutely starving and I am a cruel, cruel owner when in fact she was fed approximately 3 hours ago. I can hear her running about in another room. Cat Banshee, pretty accurate. Sure, I've got the colours entirely right on the hair, but I'm pretty happy with the overall effect. to move on to the fun job of drawing everything else. Actually, no. If I add a bit more red to this thing, I think I can make it to the colour for the other thing. I'm becoming ever more grateful I did the background for this section first. Not come quite far down enough here. Oh well, big brush, you were useful for a whole 30 seconds. I'm gonna add some of this to here, because it's too dark to be the actual shading, but this white shirt is such a negative space, maybe I'll just incorporate it anyway. It's a good thing to get rid of the grid lines anyway. Like, you know, slightly. I might change the colour of the collar on the shirt because it's red in the reference image. I mean, it's a blue in the image I'm referencing, but the colour scheme of the whole rest of the image is pretty red, so I might end up changing it to be a warmer colour. I've just noticed I have like a massive fleck of paint on the screen of my laptop, but it's over like the end stream button, and it says a touchscreen laptop, so I dare not brush it off. Absolutely, 100%. No possible negative ramifications of that.
Yeah.
I'm bringing out the big guns, the slightly larger brush. I streamed yesterday and did an entire painting just with one brush, but it was annoying as shit. So, actually using the art equipment I paid for, who could imagine that? I have this entire drawer full of brushes here, and I literally need them. The Elder art book has fallen. I have this entire drawer of like this many brushes, and I literally use this one and the other one that's already in use. It is simply tradition. I mean, some of the ones down there are like oil brushes that I don't want to try to use with acrylic, but still. The shirt is originally white in the reference image, and I kind of just put this down to display where the darker areas were, but I'm kind of liking turning this shirt slightly pink. I'm basically just putting slightly painty water on the thing at this point, which is good for spreading an even kind of colour, but also just creates so many bits of like page dust and crumbs and stuff. I'm not sure if it comes directly from the paper or if some of it's from the paint as well, but it is spilling. And it's spilling all over my new shirt. This is fine. A little bit of copium on this is fine, but you know. Once it's dry, I'll be able to just like brush them off, but annoying in the present. The desktop notification has cometh through. There's probably a way to turn those off while I'm streaming, but I do not know it. Yeah, that's probably the better idea than just... If I acknowledge it, it seems like an intentionally funny bit. hopefully, rather than what it actually is. Poor stream setup. That's the shirt just about done. It needs to be more opaque, but I think my white paint is fully coagulated. That's annoying. If in doubt, poke with the end of paintbrush to break through. There we go. Still a tiny bit of paint left in that. The Wombles song has arrived. I'm gonna try and get this painting finished today, but the fact that we're back at Wombles means the playlist is looped at least once, which means I have been streaming longer than I think I have. I think the line here is a bit too harsh. Gotta try and somehow like blend it in a bit. Thank you. slightly smaller brush for this little bit, I think. Farewell, big guns, we barely knew ye. How much water I've added to this acrylic paint, it really just proves the theory that anything is watercolour if you try hard enough. A little bit of removal of the grid lines just so they don't accidentally end up showing up on the thing. It's probably too little too late, but you know what? Better too little too late than not at all, I suppose. I've got a load of black paint on my hand. I'm not entirely sure how I've done that. That's a bit too red. A little bit better. This is coming out nice and opaque, which is good. The thing I hate is getting exactly the right colour, but the paint being too transparent and like watered down so that you can still see like grid lines and stuff through it, and then having to repaint it and find the right colour like again. That is an annoying experience in and of itself. I can see myself going down the same road I was going down yesterday where the skin ends up completely purple. But I will follow this road to its natural conclusion, I think. I'm going to try and include this painting in my coursework portfolio. So mentally I'm running through all like the random bullshit I can spew to justify how this fits into the theme. And it's not complete bullshit, but it is a little bit random. I'm gonna say this is an emulation of a certain artist that I found on Google. Oh yeah. I can't remember her name, but I did remember to bookmark the tab. There I go, I am not a complete failure of a human. Every time I hear this song, I just think of that one TikTok audio from like, oh god, it's gotta be coming on 2.5 years ago now. It's just, am I a lady or am I a rat? Best spoof of this song ever made. To add a bit more yellow to this to get it more accurate for the skin tone. Not too much though, because it might end up overpowering it. It still needs to be kind of pinky. I find that white light somehow makes like white skin look pinker for some reason, which you wouldn't think it would do, but. some random light pink acrylic paint I've had for years is just so potent for no reason. And slightly purple, but like manageably so. We'll be going now. So I did want to get this finished, but at the same time, damn, 2 hours. That's a long ass stream. My elbow's been in the way for a very long time. Desktop notification, back at it again. It's not a Hain stream without one. Or, you know, like the 4 we've had so far, whatever the count is. I may need a refill of water in the wonderful world of the wet palate. Well, the poor man's stay wet palate. Oop, just missed the water jug. That's annoying. Just checking a wet tissue underneath paint is a surprisingly good method of keeping acrylic wet for no reason at all. You can pay like 20 quid for a professional stay wet palette, which does the same thing for moderately longer. This is that's a bit too vibrant of a pink, but we will fix it in the end. I think I made the cheeks a little too pink, so I'm just trying to kind of retcon it a bit. I think I'm pulling this back from the depths of hell that is overly rose-cheeked art. Yeah, that was a sentence, yep.
We'll be right back.
much just the hands, collar, and facial features left to do, which is good because it means I might get this finished today, which means it can dry overnight, which means I don't have to work on it again tomorrow. I'm liking this like one painting in a single stream thing, because usually when I stream my like my pen drawings, it's like, surprise, we're doing the same drawing four streams in a row. I think it was three plus I recorded the last section for the last like oil painting I did. Didn't mean to leave that open. That might be a little bit much, but we were all willing with it. Trying to make the shirt a little less pink. Major random papery bits on here, but oh well. My headphones just clipped against the mic, sorry if that was kind of weird noise. I think that got a decent amount of the paper clippings off. It's probably not helping that I'm creating these paper things every time I do this, but, and that my water is very pink already. So I think I will leave that bit for a little bit. The red theme for this drawing was pretty much accidental because they just filled in like the background in red because I had it on my brush and was like, I need to wipe this somewhere. But I like the coordination it has. Get a decent color in for the lips. Hello, desktop notification. Wow, this time schedule is apparently the time when all of my desktop notifications come through for various things, which is interesting. Christ alive, today we're just running alive with desktop notifications. Finally, the moment of truth, the bandana. Kind of see the pigment like disappearing from the brush stroke as that goes along. That's kind of cool. I think I need to use a different type of brush here. Redemption arc for the weirdly wonky brush. There we go, nice and dark and opaque up here, where it needs to be. need to lighten the section of the character, of the like the white bit of the character here. Paper's kind of starting to buckle in the middle, but we're rolling with it. Time to break out the really small brushes. We're not going properly nano yet. We're not breaking out this bad boy quite yet. This should be fine enough to do like the brows and the lashes and all that section. I like these brushes because they've got like little triangular grips, which makes it quite easy to hold quite high up. Although sometimes they will just like hold like that, like I'm writing. set now, so I can brush a lot of the paper crumbs off. Just steal a bit of color off this brush just for the pupil of the side. I know I was not in any sort of minority who just completely forgot that Bo Burnham's actual name would be Robert when they first heard that song. My cat is once again on the loose, making mischief for everyone else. Good for her, I say. I haven't got any paint for this thing. Not that it would particularly matter. I think I just need to paint the shirt white and then start from the beginning in that section. I need to fix the lips. Give me a sec. I return. I'm just gonna fill that gap because I originally thought it might be reflection from the headphones, but now I'm not so sure. I've just about managed to fix that up. This is too pink now. Surprisingly, adding pink fixes that issue. This is good music to draw to at fucking 20 past 11 at night. Single power range. this was like my go-to music to listen to while I was painting for a while back in the summer. I still could not tell you the lyrics to this song. I mean, I could say some of them, but we'll be right back. not done by midnight, I am just gonna call it. Not only is it be the longest stream I've ever done at this point, but also because I have to wake up at 8 a.m. tomorrow. I can and should be using a larger brush for this bit, but oh well. I fear we may have bled through to the page underneath, but that sounds like a problem for future me to deal with. I'm not sure about the lips, but I'll try and fix them later. I'm gonna try and add some opacity for the collar section. There we go. You try and make it match the bandana spot a bit. added a little bit of capacity to it. Lightly dusting on a little bit of the paint just to add the like undertones of it. Don't want to waste too much, I'm probably just going to use straight from the pot for a little bit. Sorry. Hey, Mega Mac. I did not see you back in the chat. Thank you. I have no idea how old that message is. I am blind as a bat and unobservant as hell. Just trying to fix the shirt here at the bottom. Yeah, lurking. I know the feeling. Sometimes I'll go sit through like a 9-hour stream and not say an entire thing in people's chats. Tis the way of the lurker. paper's slightly buckled here, but there's not a lot I can do about that. I think I've significantly lightened it enough to distinguish it from the skin tones. There we go. There's my tiny brush. There it is. I think that's as good as I'm gonna get on the face for now, at least. And blend out between the dark red and the highlights of the lips, I think. There we go. Now it's all about the hand, I think, pretty much. Hey, Sol Santana! Good to see you back here! My brush is wet, that's annoying. Ah, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to you too! We have been good. This stream, you've got me pretty much right at the end of this stream. We've been going for like, how long have we been going for? 3 hours and 6 minutes, meaning this is the longest stream I have ever done. and it is almost midnight here, and I actually have college tomorrow, so I cannot do a 3 a.m. stream, regrettably. How have you been? We've just got the last details to do on this bit of hand, and then the first stage- oh, and the headphones. But then the first stage of this painting will be done. Damn, 40 degrees, that is a hell of a temperature. I'm glad Christmas is lovely. See, I cannot even fathom 40 degrees at the moment. It is properly the middle of winter here. It was actually snowing this morning. I hope it holds off on snow here until like next Monday, because then college will close for a snow day. The worst thing about like COVID digitizing learning, we don't get snow days anymore. They're just like, nah, snow can't stop you getting to your laptop. I suppose in like the hottest countries you might not really have like snow days and stuff. Yeah, the music might be a bit quiet. I kind of adjusted the settings earlier, but it might be a little quiet. If my mouse would like to synchronize, Jesus Christ. My cursor is for some reason invisible. There we go. Is that a little bit better? I've turned it up slightly. I don't know if that makes... Yeah, snow is pretty good. I've turned it up slightly. Let me know if that's a bit of a better volume. Yeah, the snow is pretty cool. I live in an area that's just fields for like miles. So whenever it snows, you can just take like dogs and stuff out and watch them just like blaze a trail through the piles. I don't know if my... Yeah, my stream might be having issues. I don't think it's my end, though. I'll see you in a sec if you've got to reset something. I will check though to see if it's working my end at all. My Wi-Fi is down a bar. Always a comforting sign. Let's play. Is it my end or is it just broken? Waving motion to test. It's coming through okay, my end, so hopefully it's not my Wi-Fi just being entirely shit. My camera's died. My camera's died. I. I think that might be the sign. Crap. The phone that I use for a camera has died. Well, fellas. Hang on. Well, we have worked out the duration of stream that my phone camera battery is capable of maintaining. Sorry if they end up ending before you get Soul Santana. But yes, the phone camera has died, and it's not really much of a painting stream if you can't actually see the painting. So, I'm going to call it a day. 3 hours, 15 minutes. And my killer hit rate is in the red. That's an interesting development. Thank you everyone who showed up to hang for the stream for a bit. It's very nice to have people to talk to when I'm doing these long painting stream things. But I will see you whenever I'm next live. God knows we don't have a schedule. Yeah. It stopped starting. Yeah, it might be my end. I see that I'm dropping a bunch of frames. My camera has died for the painting, so I'm just gonna be ending off now, I'm afraid. I'll see you hopefully next time I stream. But yeah, I'm gonna go now since there's not much point of a painting stream without view of the painting. I'll see you guys. Bye.